My name is Jonas Kuhlman. I am going to tackle the issue of shale gas as the solution to our energy problems. If you don't think that there are energy problems, just check how frequently fuel prices increased this past year alone. In fact, look at your electricity bill, food prices. Soon, you could be joining me in a state of poverty. For generations, fossil fuels have been banned to meet the world's ever-increasing energy demands. Examples of fossil fuels include coal, petroleum, and natural gas. Because it takes the natural environment millions of years to renew fossil fuels, they are considered to be non-renewable. They are estimated to produce 21.3 billion tons of carbon dioxide per year. And the atmosphere can only absorb half of this amount. Therefore, this causes a major environmental concern. Polluting air, water, and land, changing the ecosystem structure through climate change that has been caused by the excess amount of carbon dioxide that is trapped within the atmosphere. I hope you have took note of these problems. Now let's look at the proposed solution, shale gas. With reference to an article titled Shale Gas, a Reliable and Affordable Alternative to Costly Green Schemes. Yes, the article says that solar power and wind energy are schemes, as it claims that they are too expensive to produce and are not reliable as they are produced intermittently. Shale gas is extracted through hydraulic fracturing, sometimes called fracking. A mixture of water, sand, and chemicals is injected into the shale at high pressure to fracture the rock and release the gas within. Horizontal drilling is used to maximize the surface area of the borehole through which the gas is collected. The article goes on to claim that shale gas will provide affordable and reliable energy that will be more eco-friendly, and water will not be contaminated as fracking occurs thousands of feet below the aquifers. It has great economic benefits as it will create jobs and thus have a positive impact in the fight against poverty. After reading this article, I went out to do a research of my own, and this is what I found. Vegetation is cleared to install waste pipes, taking away natural habitats for some animal species. According to the European Academy's Science Advisory Council, waste material occupies a greater volume than the material extracted. And the waste materials are, of course, toxic and carcinogenic. Solid waste material is disposed in open dumps. This increases greenhouse gas emissions and water still gets contaminated. Through leaching, toxic chemicals are able to penetrate and reach the underground water tables, and thus pollute all the interconnected water systems, leading to the breakout of various diseases and increasing the mortality rate. It does have some economic benefits for some, for a while though. But really, can you drink money? Now, contrary to the author, I believe the extracting shale gas is only a money-making scheme. What further convinces me is the fact that the extraction of shale gas in the Karoo has been approved. This has been done with total disregard of a very important feature of the Karoo, the dolerite dikes. Drilling in the presence of these dikes will increase chances of underground water pollution. In addition to this, fracking can harm the Square Kilometer Array Telescope project situated in the Karoo. High pressure drilling will cause small tremors that can interfere with the project's telescopes. Now compare all these shale related problems with the ones I highlighted earlier. Is shale gas really the solution? No, it is not a solution. It is just an addition to the list of human-induced environmental disasters. Please be wise and say no to fracking. From me, it's goodbye for now.